Bulwinaka leaders, trusted, everyone is having a great time at home and being productive with their working from home or working from work. I believe these hard times, and we are trying to survive on different ends. But I believe it's also by the grace of God we've made it this far. What I'd like to share today is my topic is basically empowered by the Holy Spirit. Now, just to share a brief story, empowered by the Holy Spirit. When I first took up the challenge to take up the youth, I was into all this motivation and empowering the youth, empowering motivation, talking positive, giving back positivity to the youth. But then I later realized encouraging them and motivating them is good. But there was one issue with it. When you talk about empowerment, when you can empower their youth or empowering anyone for that matter. Empowering is basically the work of the Holy Spirit and nothing less. That's something I learned. What do I mean by this? I mean motivating your youth, and I'm talking like worldly motivation. Motivating your youth, worldly motivation. Those kind of motivations just last should be the you when you talk about the empowerment of the Holy Spirit, that one lasts a long time. Even God's love is a privilege. But the thing that sustains you in God's love is the Holy Spirit. You can't be a Christian without the Holy Spirit. Book of Romans 8:14 says, "For those who are led by the Spirit, those are the children of God." What does this mean? It means we as leaders, we need to be led by the Spirit in our decisions, in our leadership roles, we need to be led by the Spirit. The Bible in Acts 1:8, it talks about empowerment. Empowerment, what is empowerment? It's when you are given power. So the Bible in Acts 1:8 says, "And you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you." So the only time you'll be empowered is when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. Nothing else. Nothing else will empower you like how the Holy Spirit empowers you. Empowerment only comes from the Holy Spirit. It doesn't come from the world or anything. If it comes from the world, well, it's worldly motivation. So I think it's a privilege to have the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit will extra propel you in your ministry. Your goals and your plan, so it's important to pray over your plan. The Spirit, the Holy Spirit also empowers your prayer life. Romans 8:27 says, "The Spirit intercedes for the saints in accordance with God's will." What does this simply mean? It means the Holy Spirit helps us in prayer. When you pray and do not know what to pray, the Holy Spirit intercedes on behalf of us. So you see, empowered by the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit actually empowers our prayer life too. So he empowers our life. He empowers our prayer life. If it's one thing you want to empower our youth as a leader, be led by the Spirit. Empower your youth by His Holy Spirit. Nothing less.